Good morning, all the students. So yesterday we have discussed about the force. So can you recollect what are the topics we learned about the force? First we learned what is a force. So what is a force? Force is a push or pull that can change the position, change the direction, change the speed and change the shape also. Very good. And also we have seen Galileo's experiment. Do you remember? Let I recollect the Galileo's experiment. So everyone used to think that objects will be at rest. It is true. When we see around us, how do we see? All the objects are at rest only, no? So if no one is changing, the objects will be at rest. So everyone thought that every object will be at rest. But Galileo has done a spectacular experiment. So let us see that experiment now. So he has taken a smooth surface, this type of walls. And he left the ball here and he observed that the ball reaches to the same height. Yes, you can see now. He left the ball here. Then what happened? See, it is reaching to the same height. He wondered, how is happening? So he changed something. What? This slantness he changed. So what he did second time, he made more slantness. You can see that's more, I mean, less slant. He decreases the slantness. Now he left the ball. Now he observed that ball is trying to reach to that same height. This frictionless surface made the ball to reach to the same height. Now, he asked one question like this. If I made a slopeless, a perfect horizontal line, horizontal surface. Actually, you see, Nana, here, what is happening? It is reaching to that height. Again, in that reaching to the height. Now, ball doesn't know. What ball knows when it left from that place? It wants to go to that height. So, left, and it keeps on trying, so it moves with uniform motion, goes on. But if you ask, sir, it will stop now after some time, okay, yes, after some time it will stop, that is because of friction. I said at the beginning, there is no friction. Will it stop? No. So now what do you say that? If this object moves continuously, the people used to think that objects will be at rest. Now, as for this experiment, what the conclusion took him? Objects are moving with uniform motion. So this is the universal phenomenon. Object moves with uniform motion. Okay, Nana? This is what Galileo has identified. Now, we are going to see the Newton first law. What did we see in the Newton first law? Everybody will be in state of rest or in uniform motion. Rest means basing the things which are there around us. Uniform motion, universal phenomenon. Only do this. Rest or in uniform motion in a particular direction will remain to be in that same state until and unless forces acted on it, unbalanced forces acted on it. If force act on that, unbalanced force act on that, we can change the rest or we can change the uniform motion, you can change the direction. If no force apply, they will remain like that, remains like that. That's why a new terminology we have seen called inertia. Inertia. Generally, every object doesn't wants to change its state. Every object doesn't wants to change its state. That phenomenon we will call it as inertia. So, or else you can say like this, the opposition to change is called inertia. Suppose if the object is at rest, it will remain to be at rest. But if you want to change the position, first of all, it happily won't change its position. It opposes, this object opposes to change its position. The opposition we will call it as inertia. So they never wants to change, they want to remain in the same situation. So they wants to remain in the same situation. That phenomenon they want, what do we call it as? Inertia. They don't want to change, they oppose the change. The opposition to change its state we will call it as inertia. Imagine if the object is moving with uniform motion, it will continue to remain in the uniform motion. So it doesn't want to change its state, it wants to move with the uniform motion. So that phenomenon we will call it as inertia. Suppose it is going in straight direction, so it doesn't want to change its direction, it wants to go continuously in straight line. The opposition to change, what we call it as inertia. So inertias, we have seen three different types of inertias: inertia of rest, inertia of motion, inertia of direction. Three inertias are there. Now you try to say the definitions for this inertia of rest. The opposition to change the position or rest is called inertia of rest. The opposition by the body to change its uniform motion is called inertia of motion. The opposition by the body to change its direction is called inertia of direction. So they will never change until something acted on it. What is that saying? That thing only force. So as long as you do not apply force, objects will be in their inertia. Okay, now will let me understand inertia more with good examples. Inertia. You have taken a plastic ball and a cricket ball. You just try to push these as with a slight push. Give a slight push. Just give a slight push. Same from this side. Which one easily moves? Which one easily changes position? Which one turns, rolls out very quickly?
Rubber ball.
We feel hard to push it. Why? Because it doesn't want to change. It is heavier. Means, which are showing more opposition? The lighter one or heavier one? I'll say, bigger ball I take. A big football. Now big stone. It's about 100 kgs. You just try to push the same way as I said. Push. So when you try to push, what happens? Which one moves easily? The ball can move easily. It is showing less opposition to change. But it is? No. It says that I don't want to change. Because which one is heavier? This one is heavier. So heavier objects has more inertia. The objects which are having more mass are having the more inertia. The objects which are having the more mass are having the more inertia. Now, let us see some questions that are discussed in our textbook. All of you take your textbook and look at the in-text question. In-text question, what do you see there? So, they have asked you to see the rubber ball and stone. Here, that one. Which one is easy to push?
Rubber ball.
Why? Why? Because it is having less weight. This one is very difficult to push. Why? Because it is having more mass. That's why it is having more inertia. So, which objects will have more inertia? The objects which are having more mass have more inertia. They oppose always to change and they will not change their states very easily. You understood now this answer? Which one has more inertia? Rubber ball or stone? Yes, you are right, stone. Now, let us see one example. Triangle. That triangle is done. And cycle. Yeah, I asked the question. Which one has more inertia? Triangle or cycle? Yes, definitely. You will say the triangle. You cannot, if triangle stops, can you pull the triangle very easily? No. So, cycle, we can pull it. So, when we compare the triangle and cycle, we feel the more mass means the triangle has more inertia to change. Means that opposes a lot. If more mass is there, more opposition, that's why we say it has more inertia. Now, how many different types of inertia we have seen? Three. What are those? Inertia of rest, inertia of direction, inertia of motion. Now, let us see this example. I'll do one simple experiment. We will understand it better. Take a glass, empty glass, and put a cardboard and keep a 5 rupees coin here. And try to flick here. Just flick means give two lines. See how it is happening now? Flicking. What happens? This one comes out because you applied force on this object. You did not apply force on the coin. The coin is at rest. Already we have seen inertia of rest means unless force acted on it, the body will remain to be in the same state. It does not want to change its state. So it will remain in the same state. Well, fraction of milliseconds, imagine. But due to gravity, what will happen? It falls in the same water. Now, you answer to the question, why coin did not go along with the cart? Why it fell on the same glass? The answer is inertia of rest. Every body will be in state of rest. It will remain to be at rest. Here, two bodies you can see. What are those two bodies? One is card, another one is coin. Okay? You applied force on card or coin? Card. So, that's why what happened to the card? Card moved. You did not apply any force on coin. Therefore, coin remained in the same state, rest. But suddenly it saw down, it has seen down, nothing is there, the rail, it fell into the bottle. So why coin fell into the bottle when you flick the card means because of inertia, rest. Now we will see some more examples to understand the inertia. So let us see the next question. In that in-text part, you see the third question. A big tree is there with all leaves, and you are trying to push the tree. But what happens? If any dried up leaves are there, they will not interest, they are not interested to change their position, they will change. But you are pulling it. So, because of this inertia of rest, the leaves will get detached from the tree and you will see that leaves fall. See how the leaves are falling? Somebody has pushed the tree. Leaves are falling. So, inertia of rest. If the leaf is at rest, it wants to remain at rest, but you are trying to push the tree. It doesn't want to change its state. That's why the leaves detach from the tree and fall. If the body is at rest, it will remain to be at rest. That phenomenon, what do we call it as? Inertia of rest. Now, one more example we'll see so that you understand it better. And why seat belts are very important, you can come to know that. The car is moving with some velocity. Suddenly it met an accident. As it hit the wall, the car stops. But till the moment the passengers who are in the car, they are moving with the car. But because of hitting the wall, which one came to rest? Car came to rest. You can see the car came to rest. But still the passengers are in motion. So they continue to move in motion. So as it were, the passengers will come out from the windows or they will meet an accident. So it is very important to wear a seat belt while driving the car. So why? Because of this one, inertia of motion. If a car is in motion, you are also in motion with the car. But suddenly car stops. But you won't stop because you are in motion. You continue to move forward. It means you fall forward. The same thing happens when you are standing in the bus. If bus suddenly stops, the passengers in the bus, what happens to them? They fall forward because their body is moving, still moving because of inertia of motion. Okay, now if they wear the seat belts, what happens? The seat belts protects them, stops them falling forward. If seat belts are not there, they fall forward. They may hit something or they go out of the window and it causes fatal injuries. That's why wear the seat belt while you are going in the car, even though you are in front seat or back seat. It is advisable to wear the seat belt while you are going in a car or any vehicle. Next, why do we fall back when bus suddenly starts? Till that moment we are in the rest. We'll remind them in the rest. But bus started, but you did not start because you are at rest. Our legs will go with the bus, but your body, upper portion of the body is still at rest. So that's why what happens? You fell backwards. Now, so three questions we have learned now. Four questions. Why leaves fall? Why seat belt is required? Why we false friend when suddenly stops? Why we falls back when bus suddenly starts? Now can you answer for this question? I'll say why the leaves falls. Now you have to observe the two things. Which one is at rest? First, these two, tree and leaves are at rest. But you apply force on tree, but leaves are at rest. As the leaves are at rest, due to inertia of rest, these leaves will be in state of rest. But as you are pushing the tree, they will get detached and they will fall. And why seat belt is required? Here two things, car and you. In the car, you are moving along with the car in uniform motion. You are also moving, car is also moving. Because of some accident, car stops. But you still continue to move because of inertia motion. If seat belt is not there, you may cause some fatal injuries. That's why it is better to wear the seat belts. So here what did we see? Inertia of motion makes the driver or passengers in the car move continuously forward. And next, why we fall front when the bus suddenly stops? The same reason. Bus suddenly stopped, but you are still in motion. The upper part of the body is in inertia motion. That's why it goes forward. But our skeleton system makes us to break it, come it back. But if not is there, then we will fall down. And the last, why we fall back when bus suddenly starts? We are at rest, including with the bus. But the bus has moved. But our bodies did not move because inertia rest. So, but our legs are with the bus. The bus has gone. But our body still in inertia of rest. It goes like this. But because of skeleton action, it comes forward. Otherwise, we would fall back. So now I hope so that you understood inertia. Inertia means if it is at rest, it doesn't want to change its state of rest. The opposition to change the state, we will call it as inertia of rest. If a body is in uniform motion, it will continue to be in uniform motion. And it doesn't want to change this uniform motion. That opposition, we will call it as inertia of motion. If body is going in straight direction, it will continue to move in straight direction. Because that body doesn't want to change its direction. It opposes that to change the direction. That opposition, we will call it as inertia of direction. Now, to change the inertia, what we need to apply? Force. This is what we call it as Newton's first law. That's why Newton's first law is also called as law of inertia. I hope so that you understood. Now, today's work is that in-text questions are there. No, just look at the in-text questions. That those questions you please write in your classwork. Thank you.